all birds have most of their body covered in feathers. And these feathers are important for flight and for maintaining body temperature. And they're used for protection from the elements. It's like putting on a coat or a rain jacket. All birds also use feathers for some element of coloration. It might be to be more cryptic and camouflaged, or to be more conspicuous and colorful. And in Birds of Paradise, feathers are playing all those same roles. But then you have this whole other realm where not only are they colorful, not only are they being used for courtship display, but they're actually modified into something so unfeather-like in many cases that they're without precedent in all of the rest of the bird world. And that's really incredible to me, that all of these feathers that are so unusual all have their origins back to that same basic feather that we're familiar with from all those other birds. Birds of Paradise, a lot of their feathers have been modified to show off color and shape to the extent that those feathers are hardly useful. They don't help with insulation at all. The feathers have a completely different structure. If you only had those kinds of feathers, the bird would probably not survive well if it was cold and wet. A tail that's 3 feet long doesn't help with flight. It's like an airplane pulling along a huge streamer. It looks cool. It might tell us something like, come to the beach or whatever it might say, but it doesn't help the plane fly better. Some birds of paradise have feathers that have shapes that when you're looking at one individual feather, it doesn't really make sense. But then they put them together with a bunch of other feathers of unusual shapes and create these metastructures. We think of these as the shapeshifters, usually the ones that transform themselves into something very unbird-like. And those creations are created with feathers of some sort. Sometimes they're feathers of the body, sometimes they're the wings.
What are the most unusual feathers in the group?
The most unusual feathers in Birds of Paradise, and they're some of the most unusual feathers in all of birds, are the ones where what we think of as the typical feather structure has been lost. And what's happened is that the feather, which has a central shaft and all these little smaller branches that come off of it that make the vane of the feather, have been fused together so that it actually looks like a plastic tab or a piece of plastic. And that's what we see on the King of Saxony, which has feathers that come off from behind the eye, which typically should be very small. And these have been elongated through the processes of sexual selection to being twice as long as the body of the bird and fused so that you have this incredible non-feather-like plastic structure. But that's not the only instance where you see that fused plastic-like structure. We actually also see it in the tail wires or tail ribbons, because they're more ribbon-like, in the Red Bird of Paradise, which doesn't have the typical wire that we see in some of the other paradiseas, but it actually has this long, fused plastic curlicue. They're very rigid, and they hold their shape in a really unusual way. But it's the same kind of process that's gone on with the fusion of the feathers in the King of Saxony.
How does a bird control, if it's just connected to its skin, where that feather goes and how they move them around their bodies?
All birds have a set of very small muscles that are in the skin of the bird that attach to the base of every feather and can be pushed and pulled on different ways so that feathers move. And if you think about a bird that's fluffing itself up or preening, the bird can move his feathers out away from the body and back down. And so essentially what Birds of Paradise are doing with these really long and very unusual, highly modified feathers is they're doing the same thing. They're using those same sets of muscles in the skin, and they're able to move them. But what's extraordinary is that they have had some evolution going on under the surface that we can't see that's made those muscles much stronger and more robust to give them more degrees of movement than we typically think of, and also with an incredible amount of precision.
A bird like that with those incredible precision, long feathers, they don't have to grow those every year, do they?
All the feathers on the bird are regrown every year, so it doesn't matter whether they're just the tiny normal contour feathers, or they're the 3 foot long tail feathers on the ribbon tail dystrapia. Somehow all of those feathers are regrown every year, as improbable as it seems. Even when you see a bird that's regrowing them, it's hard to believe that it can regenerate something so unusual over the course of the year, and usually it's only in the course of several months. So when we think of birds, I think we often think of two things, feathers and flight. But something that birds of paradise have in their feathers that's not as common among most birds is how extremely modified the feathers have become to be used as vehicles of carrying color or ornaments that can help change their shape and appearance. So it's this kind of gross modification of the feathers for no other purpose than for courtship that really makes the birds of paradise stand out among the whole bird world for types of feathers and how they're used.